Good afternoon. Have you ever felt like your life was at a dead end? Have you ever been on the road and seen a stop sign or a dead end and not known where to go? Today, your situation may seem like there is no end to your suffering, but I'm here to tell you that there is a finish line. But sometimes when the finish line is difficult to reach, we can hit dead ends if we let ourselves. There are three types of dead ends I want to share with you today. The first one is sinning. Galatians 6:7 says, "Do not be deceived. God is not mocked." We are living in a generation today who has fooled themselves into thinking that they can get away with sin. Psalms 10:11 tells us the reason why people sin. We say to ourselves, "God has forgotten. He covers his face and never sees sin." But look back in Galatians where it plainly tells us that God is not mocked. He will not be made a fool of. If you're caught up in sin, then you need to get out of it. Because sin takes you further than you want to go, costs you more than you want to pay, and it keeps you longer than you want to stay. The price of sin is costly. Today the enemy tells you that you can't and you won't. But I'm here to declare to you that Jesus says you can and you will overcome this dead end. Yes. Romans 12 verse 2 says, "Do not conform, but be transformed." The second dead end is not serving. As a group of believers, we were called where we are today for such a time as this. Not serving others prevents the Great Commission and what we as Christians are really called to do. In Matthew 28:19, Jesus tells us to go and make disciples of all nations. Ephesians 5:1 says we need to imitate God. We need to go out like Jesus did, go out to the lost, show them his love, and gently guide them back to truth. We need to teach them to know him, to love him, to hear him, and to experience him. We need to stop leaving them at the altar and start leading them to the one who alters, the yes. one who fixes their brokenness, the one who shows them how to live. Yes. Because they don't just need a church experience. They need an everyday encounter. The last dead end I want to share with you this afternoon is waiting on the Lord. Today, we all want everything now, in our timing and according to our plan. However, in this waiting, God is pulling life together. Isaiah 40:31 says, "But those who wait for the Lord will renew their strength." God is not limited by time, but time is limited by God. Mark Batterson said, "The plans of God are found in the presence of God." Let's go back to the very first question I asked you today. Have you ever felt like your life was at a dead end? The date was May 14th, 2012. My older sister had attempted suicide. My mother had found her early that afternoon, hanging from a dumpster, breathless and at a dead end. Confused and heartbroken, I began to claim life over my sister's situation. I remembered God's promise in 2 Timothy 1:12, which says, "And for this reason I suffer as I do. But I am not ashamed, for I know the one whom I have put my trust." As time went on, I was able to see God's mighty healing hand on her life as she walked away from this dead end, alive and whole. This afternoon, your situation may seem like it is a dead end, but today I have come to declare to you that there is hope in your situations. When tragedy strikes and hard times come, you need to say, "I know I can make it." Maybe today you are struggling with your health, but you need to say, "I know I can make it. My future is falling apart faster than I can put the pieces together. But I know I can make it." Maybe today you look at me and you just say, "I'm struggling with a sin and I just can't get rid of it." But you need to say, "I know I can make it." 1 John 4:4 says, "Greater is he who is in me than he who is in that world." I think we often get caught up in the drama and distractions around us and forget that God is all-powerful, all-capable, and all-knowing. He isn't just a God of sometimes, but a God of always. Jeremiah 29:11, one of my favorite verses in the Bible, says, "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you a hope and a future." You may fall down, but you've got to press. God will turn your dead end into a finish line. You just have to press through the sin, pray for courage to serve, and have patience to wait for God's timing. Will you trust God and allow him to map out your race? Or will you hit a dead end and fall behind? Thank you.